This is the Catholic Daily Journal for Tuesday, April the 9th, 2019. It's the birthday in 1458 of Camilla Battista da Verano, an Italian princess and a poor Clare nun. She was born out of wedlock to the Duke of Camerino, Giulio Cesare de Verano, and was raised at court. At the age of 10, she heard a sermon about the value of meditating upon the crucifixion on Fridays. This led her to up her game spiritually by regular fasting and by keeping all-night vigils. Now, this didn't stop her from playing music and singing and dancing and generally living the courtly life, but eventually these two aspects of her life came more and more into conflict. And around her 20th birthday, she found herself in full crisis. Her father wanted her to marry, and she wanted to devote herself entirely to the religious life. After 3 years of arguing and praying, the Duke consented to her joining the Poor Clares. She was elected abbess several times, but she's most remembered for her mystical visions of Jesus, which are recorded by no less than St. Alphonsus Liguori. She wrote about these herself and about many other topics, from theology to governance. And after her death in 1524, both St. Philip Neri and St. Alphonsus wrote in praise of her. Today in 1945, the Polish/Prussian theologian Dietrich Bonhoeffer died in Flossenbürg concentration camp in Germany. Bonhoeffer's book, The Cost of Discipleship, is one of the modern classics of the spiritual life. In it, he distinguishes between cheap grace and costly grace. Cheap grace, he says, is easy. It requires little, and it consoles little. It doesn't do much to get us to heaven, and it doesn't do much to save us from hell. Costly grace, though, requires much from us. It's that hill worth dying on. It's the grace, the nearness to God, that is worth living and dying for, and which makes life worth living. Much like Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s writings from prison, the cost of discipleship isn't precise theology. It's not careful, footnoted, linguistically sharp theology like St. Augustine or St. Thomas Aquinas, and it shouldn't be read like it is. It's a heart, suffering trials, trying to understand the cross not as a theory, but as a reality. And when we read The Cost of Discipleship, we shouldn't try to make his categories our own categories. We should empathize with his effort to understand and to take that same effort up in our own lives, that desire to understand. Bonhoeffer's understanding of grace is analogous to St. John of the Cross's understanding of faith. It's not a system of theology. It's one man trying to understand what the Lord is saying to him and using the language at his disposal. And The Cost of Discipleship is worth reading. Today in 1682, the French explorer René Robert Cavalier Sieur de la Salle, what a name, finished an epic canoe trip from the mouth of the Illinois River to what is now Venice, Louisiana, and the mouth of the Mississippi River, where he buried an engraved plaque and a small cross, and he claimed the whole region for France. And its name he declared to be La Louisiane for King Louis XIV. Now we have to say that the French explorers Joliet and Marquette were actually the first Europeans to discover the mouth in 1674 or so. But René Robert Cavalier Sieur de la Salle got credit, and his name, La Louisiane, stuck. He also established Fort Prudhomme in what is now Memphis, Tennessee. Today, two Canadian cities bear his name, as do two U.S. counties, one in Illinois and one in Texas, and one Louisiana parish, which is what Louisianians call a county. Strangely, La Salle Parish in Louisiana is distant from the Mississippi River, but it does contain one heck of a fishing lake. The Catholic Daily Journal is supported by listeners like you. For more information, visit CatholicUnderground.com. And until next time, be on the lookout for the Lord at work in your life.